You've heard much of it before, but I will echo how fantastic it is for us to be here this evening, and how wonderful to see that you've all come to watch, to listen, and to be entertained by the Evening Concert. When I received Andy's email a few months back saying we'd really like to put the concert back on, I don't think it would be an exaggeration to say that there was a lump in my throat. And then when I got to stand up in front of the band the following Thursday and say, we're going to go back and do the Cobblestone School concert, there was definitely a bit of a chunk. If you are a musician and music is what you've trained to do since you were about five, when somebody says, you can't do that anymore, stay in your house, lock yourself away, don't see any of your friends for 2 years, especially if you play a wind or a brass instrument, you think, well, that was not a good use of a degree, several thousand pounds, and many, many, many hours since. So I am truly delighted to be here. I'm so pleased that you've all come out. The band deserves every applause you can find it within yourselves to give this evening, because to bring the band back together after 2 years of not playing together, that was, we did have doubts. A few good friends, we discussed it. Do you think the over 50s band will ever play together again? And I hope from our first march to you this evening, you can say it was jolly worthwhile doing so. Give them a round of applause. So we started with a march by a composer called Robert Brown Hall called Death or Glory, which frankly seemed fitting to bearing into account everything that I've just said. And the next piece we're going to play is a euphonium solo. As you may remember if you've been here before, it takes a lot to get up and say, I'm going to do that, especially if you volunteer, which Nick Codd has done on euphonium, and he's going to play for us this evening, Bleed and Races. And I'm going to make sure he doesn't trip over his cable. got any more of those plaques left in there? Yeah. Well done, Nick. Now, I mentioned that during COVID, good friends in the band had to basically put up with me whinging all the time. Michael is the chairman of the band, and he said, "Well, I've been keeping busy. I've been practicing a solo." I'm not sure if he feels now that it was worth it, but I really, really do. I think you did really well. Well done. Very well done. We also lost a great many names in pop music, in film and television, but in classical music as well. And one of those was actually the lyricist Stephen Sondheim passed away. So this evening I wanted to honour that, and we're going to play a selection from the musical that he wrote with Leonard Bernstein, West Side Story.
Thank you.
come back and think, right, we've got to do the really good pieces. And those of you who are singing along and for giving us your applause at the end, thank you, because people singing along is one of the most sort of heartwarming and feel-good things that you can get, especially when you come to a concert like this. Some of you may know the band plays outdoors in the summer up in Felixstowe, on a triangle in the middle of the town centre. And it's lovely to be here, indoors, not fighting against the buses, trying to make myself heard, trying to make ourselves heard. And I hope you can tell by the way the band plays the piece that after being outdoors for so many Thursday afternoons in a row, it's really great to have an evening concert to enjoy the kind of music that you just can't hear the quiet bits and the beautiful bits quite so well when you're outdoors. So thank you for enjoying West Side Story. I did, and I hope that at least some of the band did as well. Speaking of music to enjoy and thinking about, like, what do we want to really play, what's really worthwhile getting out of the library, you can't plan a concert of great British music without including the Beatles. And I couldn't decide which Beatles number we were going to play, so we have something that's entitled, very glamorously, Beatles Medley Number 2. See how many favourites you can pick out.
Thank you.
counted correctly. And there are a good many sayings that you can use in concerts. Sometimes we go for now for something completely different. Sometimes we go for if you like this, if you like that, you like this. And the next number fits into both of those categories. Sometimes members of the band look to me for advice, guidance, authority. Sometimes, not very often, just occasionally. And then we get a Beatles number, and I say, well, most of you folks, with the greatest respect, know better how it goes than I do. And I think the same is probably true. Although I do have the Scylla Greatest Hits album, and I do like it, and if you've been coming to this concert a few years, you've heard me and seen me in a little dress and some boots doing a Scylla impression. I don't know if any of you remember it, but I did. This is another Scylla impression. This one is not for singing, but for the flugelhorn, played by Jo Burgess. This is Alfie. When we used to come the day, there were lots of flags hanging from the ceiling. Do you remember those? But if you didn't have a flag in your hand, you might have been tempted to clap along. And you've probably heard us play this before. It's the Radetzky March. So if your fingers aren't hurting from cheering all our soloists, you can clap along to the Radetzky March.
Yeah. Oh, we decided in the interval that if we did Rule Britannia, you wouldn't mind if we packed up and went home. Because that's what you came for, right? And we thought the more astute among you might have noticed something that was in that first piece that I shall refer to in a moment. And that was called Famous British Marches. So you had quite a few from around the British Isles, many of which you would expect to hear when we're doing a bit of pomp and circumstance and flag waving later on. But we're now going to go on a very brief whistle-stop tour of the British Isles and visit, I think, Bonnie Scotland for you next. I'm not going to do any accents. Well, don't tell me there are some Scots in the audience. Yeah. Hey, brilliant. Fantastic. We better skip this one just in case it's not good. So if you were paying attention, you might have heard something from Wales in Famous British Marches. Someone knows the answer? Men of Hyde. Fantastic. So we've had Wales. So you can put a little tick in that box. And now we're going to go up to Scotland and we're going to give Highland Cathedral.
Thank you.
I told you it was going to be a very quick tour. So if it was a little bit dank, and a little bit cloudy, and a little bit chilly up in Scotland, how are you going to feel if we get on the ferry and we go over to Ireland? I don't know if you remember Riverdance and Michael Flatley. My sister, just a little bit younger than me, she tap danced, and when the DVD of Riverdance came out, she and her friend watched it, and bear in mind, you know, quite a small TV, right in front of us, we had Riverdance. And then Michael Flatley got a bit fed up of being told what to do, so he went and started Lord of the Dance. And Jo, who played the flugelhorn solo earlier, her granddaughter, now stars in the 25th anniversary show of Lord of the Dance. And I said, you've got to come and do it. But I tell you, it's amazing. She's absolutely brilliant. And we would have had her here if we could have possibly persuaded her, but it couldn't be. Nevertheless, if you want to close your eyes and either think of Michael Flatley or the lovely lady or the ginger cows, then whichever. But this is Lord of the Dogs.
Thank you.
I hope you enjoyed your whistle stop tour. There was a moment where I was almost tempted. I thought, oh, I've got good heels on, I can rip. But then I thought, no, you're nearly 40 now. Don't need to think about it, so I don't know. You should be relieved. Thank you very much, band, because that's a really long piece of music. We're really going to play a little bit of it. Yeah, brilliant. And I'm so glad that you enjoyed it. Now, this is to warm up your singing voices in our next number. I mentioned that whilst we were at home with COVID, we lost a number of great souls from the musical world. And one of them was Dame Vera Lynn. And at the end of this, you get a chance to sing We'll Meet Again. So hold that, and hopefully we'll see you all again next year. And there's about another third of the hall left. So you can bring a friend, and there'll still be plenty of room. The piece is entitled Keep Smiling Through, which I also feel is very apt for that time that we were in. So with a number of other tunes, you have to pick them out as we go through. This is Keep Smiling Through, finishing with We'll Meet Again.
Thank you.
Steve has fallen asleep. At least I think that's what they're for. It might come in useful. But Andy would have heard me say this before. I'm quite strict. Some of the band have to put up with me, not just on a Thursday afternoon, but on a Wednesday evening, and sometimes on a Tuesday as well. When we do Land of Hope and Glory for the first time, can you just hum? Who's been to the last night of the proms? Anybody? There we go. So you pros, show the rest of them how it's done. When we do it at the first time, we just go, and we'll try and play really quietly, and we'll see if we can hear you. Then the second time you can really go for it, it's fine.
Thank you.
thank you very much. I think for many of the band and for me, it is a great honour to play some of these pieces of music. More so this year, after the passing of Queen Elizabeth, more so from the fact that the last night of the Proms in the Albert Hall was actually cancelled this year in her honour. So to be able to come and play those pieces of music and have an audience sing, wave the flags, and enjoy being together and just have that affirmation is really lovely. Thank you very much. Thank you. Those thanks to say some particular ones in the band. We played the Beatles medley in the first half, and we have another arrangement of Beatles songs in which you have the tune With a Little Help from My Friends. And with us this evening, the brass band community is a wonderful thing. Once you open it, you'll never have a free evening again in your life, or free Sunday afternoon for that matter. But there are always people you can call on when you need a helping hand. So particularly thanks to Mark this evening, to Jonathan, to Ian, but most especially to a young man who's I couldn't thank in the first half because he'd have probably driven off in the interval. There are a couple of other people who don't necessarily fit the qualification of being the over 50s brass band. And one of them is a young man called Reese, who people over on that side might not be able to see. But Reese, for the benefit of the others, just give us a wave. There we are, sitting there on percussion. Now, several people this evening in the audience and in the band said, oh, how's your husband? Well, unfortunately, he's at home with the dreaded coronavirus. I haven't seen him for 2 days. He also plays the drums. And when he came up to the bedroom at 10:15 on Monday evening and said, slight problem. Obviously, I was 99.9 concerned for my poor sick husband. And only 0.1% concerned for my concert on Wednesday evening. However, I sent Reese's mum a little message and just said, Lindsay, help, help. And Reese stepped up to the plate and was like, yeah, all right. And we had a little run through yesterday evening, just made Reese, and was like, yeah, that's good, yeah, that's good, yeah, great. And he's just played the whole concert this evening, ladies and gentlemen. No rehearsal, never played with that before. And was it yesterday or Monday you passed your driving test? It was Monday you passed his driving test. And it was nice knowing you didn't. Reese is probably never going to speak to me again. Thank you very, very much. And to you all, who've absolutely blown the tops off your instruments this evening. I know we were all delighted to come and do this concert tonight, and I know we slogged through many Thursday afternoons to make it happen, but being here and sharing this all with you is marvellous.